Welcome to a quick tutorial on StreamNow Lite for Windows. This program can be used while StreamNow is suffering outages. It unfortunately does not include all features, but it can be used as a quick workaround whilst fixes are being put in place. The program allows the user to play sounds for up to 5 levels of gifts, a sound for new subs, and displays current, silenced users and watching mods. It also allows for the integration of top fans and broadcast goals into OBS, as well as general stream information. Again, this program is currently only available for Windows. To begin, download StreamNow Lite, link in the description, and place it where you'd like to run the program. For this example, it is in an empty folder I've created. This program will only work whilst you're live, so testing using a different account that is live is advised. After launching the program, you'll be asked if you want to use saved data. As this is the first time launching, please type no. Afterwards, you'll be prompted to input your channel name, a like and share goal if you'd like to, and the symbol that will appear after the number in top fans. If you have a sub button, you'll also be asked if you'd like to set a sub goal. After letting it load for a moment, you'll be greeted by your silenced users and current watching moderators. However, you haven't finished setup yet. Proceed to close the program and find the automatically created folder called Music. This will be where you put in your sounds. Find which sounds you'd like to use and put them into this folder. You must have 5 sounds. These will be from small gifts to huge gifts. Starting from the smallest, these must be called the following for this to work. Audio 1, Audio 2, Audio 3, Audio 4, and Audio 5 for the biggest of gifts. An additional sound named Subsound must also exist if you have a sub button. All of these sounds must be in the format known as .wav. You can convert any existing files into .wav at freeconvert.com. Link in the description. After adding all your sounds, you can launch the program again, and now that you have your data saved, you can type yes for a quick start, or if you'd like to re-input your information and goals, just type no again. And that's it! The program will run as long as it's open and your stream is live. To add the information into OBS, all you must do is add a new text GDI Plus source to your scene. Name this whatever you'd like, change the font if you wish, and now, most importantly, click the setting Read from File. Upon enabling the setting, click Browse, and select the text file you wish to have in your scene. These can be found in a folder called Text Files, which can be found where your program is located. You can also find your saved data here as well. Feel free to use as many of these text files as you'd like. And that's how you use StreamNow Lite. Event Tracker is currently not possible with this program, along with several other key StreamNow features, but we hope this quick workaround will help whilst we deliver on important fixes. We are incredibly sorry about the major outages recently, and we hope to have StreamNow back online as soon as we can. Thank you.